energy vibration reading for the first week of July 2018. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. This month of July has 4 weeks, and in those 4 weeks, we are just going to do one long video for each and every person because of I'm very busy, and I can't leave out this week. I'm so sorry. So I'm just going to do one long video and then put the timing in there. Okay, we're looking at the birthday people in the month that is begin from the 1st of July until the 7th of July. Okay, so wonderful energies for the people who were born on the 1st of July. You have this year that is about to start, which is 2018. I'm sorry, it's the dog. You have the energy of information coming at you, so expect a lot of information coming at you, and a lot of situation that is going to be happening in your life, and positive situation that is going to be happening, because information is going to come in for you guys, but it's going to be a wonderful situation and it is going to be good. Okay, then we are going to look and see what other energies you're going to be working with. For the people who were born on the 1st of July, you're going to be working with some heartbreaks. So information could be coming in about heartbreaks, losing something, or missing something. So be aware of this in your life. As we look at the people who were born on the 2nd of July, this is Monday, the 2nd of July, you have the energy of the world. So the year 2018 is going to be a wonderful, wonderful, positive energy, because there's the ending of a situation and a new beginning that is coming in. So for people for the 2nd of July, let's see what else you're dealing with. You have the energy of the world, but you also have a happy family situation. So whatever the ending is that it's going to bring forth. So this is for the people who were born on the 2nd of July for the year 2018. Whatever that was in the past that has ended, there is going to be a new positive situation that is coming in, family situation. As we move forward, we're looking at a new start for the people who were born on the 3rd. People who were born on the 3rd of July, we have a new start. So 2018, after your birthday, you're going to be it could be changing jobs, changing situation in your life, whatever it is, there is a new start that is coming in. And we're going to be looking at, for the people 3rd of July, what is the year 2018 going to bring you? What else? It is going to bring you a lot of money, a lot of money. So the people who were born on the 3rd of July, you're having a new start and a positive new start in your financial situation. Money is going to be coming at you and flowing at you in the year 2018. Okay, so let's look at happy 4th of July. Happy 4th of July to each and every person out there. July is going to, this year 2018 is going to bring you situations to deal with, organization, groups of people, and that sort of a situation. So 2018 is, I hope the 4th of July is going to be a wonderful day for you, because we are going to be looking to see what is going to be coming up in the year 2018 for the people who were born on the 4th of July. What is coming up for the people in 2018 who were born on the 4th of July? You are going to be having some boredom. It could be that you've reached a stage in your life that you're looking for something more, something much better. You could be working in an organization and you're thinking, okay, I've seen everything and I'm looking for something else. So in this year, it is as if you're bored. You're looking for something else that is going to be coming up. So that's for the people who were born on the 4th of July. Now, for the people who were born on the 5th of July for the year 2018, it's all about love. You could be meeting new people, making new alignments, meeting your soulmate, and that sort of a thing. And it's going to be perfect because we are going to ask the angels and guide what is going to be coming up for the people who were born on the 5th of July. What is 2018 looking like for them? I told you, love is in the hair. So for congratulations, some of you could be getting married, some of you could be basically connecting with the right people at the right time and the right situations in your life. So be aware that love is coming in, not only in business but in a relationship. Some people could be getting married and some people could be finding their soul mate. So this is good. So for the people who were born on the 6th of July, you have victory and success. This is also, you could be moving, you could be traveling, you could be deciding to move to another state or another city, or you could be just leaving the whole continent. Whatever you decide to do, it's going to be positive. So let's see what is coming out for the people who were born on the 6th of July for the year 2018. Let's see what is happening. Our ending is coming to a situation, and this ending that is coming in, a transition is going to be happening in your life, a very positive transition. So it's as if there was a situation that you were going through and now you're ending the situation and moving forward to something much better in your life. So 2018 is going to bring you transitions, ending. It could be that some of you could be losing someone in the spirit world that is crossing over in 2018. Let's see what is happening for the people who were born on the 7th of July. You have the energy of strength in this year. Energy of strength is number 8 energy. So there could be your financial situation, your stability, your material world could be also getting better. Okay, it's not only about strength. Some of you are going to be finding inner strength for the year 2018, but it's going to be in a very positive way. So let's see what basically is going to be happening for the people who were born on the 7th of July. Victory and success. So whatever the situation is and was that you had to find inner strength for, you people who was born on the 7th of July, this is going to be very, very positive, and it's going to be coming out in a very, very positive way. Okay, so kudos to you guys, and I'm wishing you a wonderful positive year, because I'm seeing a lot of situation that is coming in. Whatever the loss is, there is a positive new beginning that is going to be coming in. Okay, a lot of love, a lot of people are going to be connecting in love, but you're also, there are people who are going to be connecting in a positive way, where you're going to be connecting with a lot of people and they are going to be aligning you with the right situations in your life. Okay, so again, happy birthdays to all you Cancers, and I am going to be saying I'm wishing you a wonderful week and a wonderful birthday. Okay, now I'm going to do the general readings because I'm so late. There's so much things that is going on. So I'm just going to do a 3 cards reading. I'm going to do a 3 cards reading, and this 3 cards reading is going to be for the weekly readings for you guys, because I can't do a really outbreed one. Okay, so let's see. For the Aquarians, what is going to be happening for the Aquarians for the first week of July 2018? For the Aquarians, you have the energy of the Queen of Pentacles. You Aquarians are going to be dealing with someone, a lady over the Queen of Wands. I'm sorry, a lady that is over the age of 40, that is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, and another lady is over the age of 40, that is an Aquarius, which is, could be you guys. So let's see what else is coming up. And the Knight of Wands, the Knight of Wands. Okay, so what I'm receiving for you Aquarians is For the young people, it's going to be a wonderful the outcomes is going to be the energy of Page of Coins, the energy of the Page of Coins. Okay, so energy of the Page of Coins is the outcome. So for some of you ladies over the age of 40, some of you ladies, gentlemen, over the age of 40, what is happening is that there is going to be a situation that either you're going to be receiving a letter or an invoice or something that has to do with money. Okay, it could be coming from the Queen of Wands, who is an Aries, a Leo, or a Sagittarius, and whoever this person is, it has a connection with the Knight of Wands. The Knight of Wands, it is and someone between the ages of 25 and 45 that is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. So this is playing out where the people over the age of 40, there is going to be a lot of situation that is coming up, a lot of situation that is happening in this week, and it has to do with these fire sign people, because some of it could be the people between the ages of 25 and 45 that you have to deal with, the fire sign people, the Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. But whatever it is that you're going to be standing up and using your intellect to align yourself with whatever that is transpiring in this week. Okay, so it could be that some of you ladies are having a conflict with someone who is it could be a mom, or it could be your sister or your mom or your grandmother or your sister-in-law or the neighbors, who is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, and it has to do with your son, it has to do with your daughter, whatever the conflict is, and it's you are standing up for yourself. It can be that you or having a conflicts because of your partner, with your partner's family, and that sort of a situation. It could be when I'm receiving that it was a wedding or something like that. It was a wedding, and then the wedding didn't, you know, whatever has transpired is as if it didn't happen as it should, where not everyone paid what they were supposed to pay, and now is there a conflict that is going on. So this situation could be transpiring for you guys. Okay, so align yourself with resolving whatever the situation is, and it will be okay. All right, so I have to take pictures because I have to do the energies of this also for the other sign that I'm using. So I'm wishing you guys a wonderful week. Namaste. Let's look at the energies for the Geminis. What is going to be happening for the Gemini sun, moon, and rising sign first week of July 2018 for the Geminis. We have the energy of the Eight of Wands, so a lot of information are going to be coming in. And the Six of Swords, you're leaving a situation behind. And the Nine of Swords, so there is a lot of swords energy. There's a lot of thoughts, there's a lot of you deciding. The Ace of Pentacles is coming up. So the outcomes of your week, you Geminis, is going to be the Eight of Pentacles. So whatever has been happening, whatever has been transpiring, the outcomes of your week is going to be the Eight of Pentacles. Now, I've read your reading. Actually, it wasn't reverse. It was good, because it's based off what is the situation. Okay, so this week, it's a mini reading. So There is going to be a situation where a lot of information is coming at you. A lot of information could be coming at you. It can be in a positive way or it can in a negative way. Now, the Six of Swords is when we decided that we're, it's either that you want to stop the information that is coming at you. It could be text message, it could be people connecting with you or that sort of a thing. But it's all over money. So, it can be for a lot of you that you're going to be worried about your financial situation, and it can be in a good sense, and it can be in a sense where you're worrying over something that you don't need to worry about, that things is going to be okay, that your financial situation is going to come in balance. But as always, you Geminis are always thinking further. It's always you're in your head. It's a thought. It's all about money for you guys in this week. It's all about how am I going to align myself to make sure that my financial situation is balanced out. It's all about money for you guys in this week. So not to worry. It's going to be a week where you're aligning yourself with the right situation, the right way, the right form of how you can attract more financial stability in your life. Okay, so I'm basically loving this for you, Geminis. And we are moving on. I'm wishing you a wonderful week. We're moving on, and we're going to be looking at the Librans. What's happening for the Librans in this week? What is happening for the Librans for the first week of June? The Librans. What is happening for the Librans? There is the energy of the Four of Wands. So, this could be stability coming in your life, but yet still, it could be if you're looking for a house, a new place, or that sort of a thing. This is going to be a pairing. Energy of the Fire is coming in. And then we have the energy of the Two of Coins that is here, which you need to make a decision. It could be a new house. Ace of Pentacles is here. So there is, you are going to have the financial situation and the Six of Swords. So how do we look at this? Is that for you, Librans? Whatever is happening, some of you could be looking for a new place, and you receive information about multiple, or you could have looked at two places. You could be buying a house, or you could be looking for a house, or it could be multiple job opportunities. And but it's more of a house. It's more of a house. It's more of a some place that you are going to do business of that sort of a thing. But you need to make a decision. You need to make a decision, and some of you are worried, are you going to have the money? And they are saying yes. So, but whatever is happening, you need to make a decision. The decision needs to be made, and whenever the decision is made, the money is going to come to you. And it's as if you're waiting, you have been waiting for this money, you have been waiting for this to come out, and you have been so waiting. And now the waiting is over. The waiting is over. It's as if whatever the situation is that you were waiting, it's as if you were waiting for something to resolve. And in this week, it's going to be resolved, and the money is going to be available. Some of you who could be selling a house, you could receive a bid on a house, and you're deciding, should I take this bid or should I just wait? And make the decision and take it, because you'd never know if there is another one that is going to be coming in. And as you do that, you're going to be realizing that this is going to be working out in a positive way for you guys. Okay, it could be a decision on the work situation, that multiple job opportunities come in. This is going to bring you financial stability, and it's going to be okay. So it's a wonderful way to basically begin your week. And the new month for you, Librans, and it is in a positive way. Okay, so not to worry about that. Okay, we're gonna move on to the Tauruses. So let's see what's happening for the Tauruses, because it's a fire week. It's the air week. It's the air week with a zodiac energy of water. Let's see what is coming in for the Taurus Sun, Moon, and Rising sign for the first week of July. Okay, for you Tauruses, I'm doing a 3-card reading this week, and your cards already fall out. So for you Tauruses, you have the energy of the Emperor. So this is good. This a Monday, Tuesday, this is going to be a very, very positive Monday, Tuesday. You are going to be working very hard. It could be connecting with situation, but it could be yourself. So Monday, Tuesday, good news is going to be coming about work for you. This is positive. Monday, Tuesday, it's going to be very positive. Wednesday, Thursday, you're going to go on a new journey, which is a very, very positive. Friday, Saturday, the weekend is the end of a situation, and you're going to be starting on a new journey. I'm loving this for you, Taurus. It just fell out, and they're saying that you have a strong foundation. So, positive energies, major arcanas, which is aligning you in this week with positive situation, okay? Because this is letting you know at work or at home, there are strong foundation. Your week is going to be a very, very positive, because beginning of the week is going to be extremely positive, because you're going to be having situations to do with work, situations to do with your business, and this is going to be good. Some of you are going to be aligned and begin new business, new work opportunities, and you're going to be ending a cycle in your life. And this new situation is going to bring positive situation, positive luck is going to be coming in, and in a very, very positive way. So this is basically good to align you with the beginning of the month of July for you. Tauruses, I'm loving this, because this is bringing positive energy. So most of you are going to be having a new start, a very, very positive new start that is going to be happening for you guys in a wonderful way. And with this new start, you are going to be aligning with the energies of who you are, and this a new business or new situation that you're about to start is going to bring you positive energies. Okay, so congratulations, you Tauruses. I'm wishing you all the luck. So we're moving on to the Virgos to see what's happening for the Virgos for the first week. Let's see what's happening for the Virgos for the first week. The Virgos, first week of June. Let's see. This week is the week of the air energies and the zodiac energies of water. Virgo, Sun, Moon, and Rising sign for the first week of July. What's happening for you guys? You have the energy of the sun. Isn't that wonderful? And the Ten of Cups. Isn't that beautiful? The Page of Swords. So, Monday, Tuesday, you are going to be having the energy of the sun. You're going to be feeling vitalized. You're going to be feeling positive, uplifting. And it has to do with family situation, okay? So whatever that was going in the family, now there is balance, there's stability, there's happiness, there's joy. Everything is going to be okay. And then you have the energy of the page of a page coming in with a message. Now this could be a positive message that is coming in to let you be aware and aligned with who you are, the family, whatever that was happening in the past, the family outcomes is going to be the Nine of Wands. You're ready for anything. So this is good. This is wonderful, because what has happened, what has transpired for you Virgos is that Monday, Tuesday, things are going to be looking up for you. Wednesday, Thursday, there's going to be a situation with a family Thursday, Friday, you're going to be receiving positive messages. The messages can be coming in Thursday, Friday, or in the weekend. And the weekend, there is going to be, you're going to be ready for anything that is happening. I'm seeing the energy of the lovers here. So some of you who were having relationship problems, this is going to be balancing out. I'm seeing that you are ready for anything that is about to happen in the family. I'm seeing positive energies are here. A lot of people are going to be feeling good Monday and Tuesday. The week is a positive week because, you know, information are going to be coming in about the family or from the family, or there is an alignment of positive news that is coming in for the family. Some of you are ready for anything that is coming your way. It's as if you're thinking, okay, I am aligned. I'm going to align myself and be ready for whatever is coming in because I know I can deal with it. There is a lot of happiness and joy. News is coming in, and some of you are going to be receiving news from an ex-lover, someone of the past, someone who you have met and haven't seen for a while is going to be coming back in your life. So this is just the sun with the 10 of cups is just bringing this week to a positive energy and with balance. Okay, this is in an extremely, extremely positive way. So congratulations, you Virgos, and I'm wishing you a wonderful, positive week. As we go and we look at the Capricorns for the first week of July. What is happening for you, Capricorns? Obviously, you guys are already here. There is a message coming up for the Capricorns. We're going to look at that message. News are going to be coming, a lot of news. This could be in text messages. I'm seeing this. So the Ace of Cups. Can you guys see that? The Ace of Cups. It was the first one that fell out. The Ace of Cups. The Ace of Cups is a message of new love coming in. Wonderful new loving energies and a lot of messages. Some of you could be reconnected with someone in the family or just people aligning with you and letting you be aware of how much they appreciate who you are. And this message is going to be coming in, a lot of messages. So it could be you are aligned with someone who a love partner or that sort of a thing. But whatever is happening, a lot of you Monday, Tuesday are going to be receiving really wonderful positive messages coming at you. Okay, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, the King of Pentacles. This King of Pentacles could be someone of the past. It could be someone, especially you men. There is going to be positive energies coming out. Okay, there could be new babies coming in the family. There could be outcomes working together. Okay, so let's see what is happening for you, Capricorn men. And you know, sorry, we should talk about the love first, but for you Capricorns, it's as if new love is going to resurge in your life. It's going to surge in your life. It's going to be coming at you. This could be in people sending you text messages. I'm seeing a lot of text messages, a lot of messages happening. There are people that wants to connect with you, people that wants to work with you, people who appreciate who you are. That is coming in. You men are going to be financial stability. So you Capricorn men are going to be sitting well. It's as if you men are holding something. You are basically holding on something and you're not showing your hands what you have. But money is as if, because the Capricorns, always want a financial stability, and this is going to be happening for you men. Some of you are going to be finding the right partnership for it to be happening. Some of you are going to be very happy doing that, because you're going to be understanding how this is going to be changing your life in like a positive way. I'm seeing that with the new love that is coming in for the ladies, you're going to be connecting with new love partners. It could be flirting, it could be you know, people just want to align with your energies of whatever is going on. For the men, I'm seeing you thinking about your financial stability, and you're holding on whatever you have. People wants to align with you, to work together with you, to bring you a stable financial situation. And that will happen for some of you if you open up and align with the energies. But I'm seeing a lot of positive energies coming in for the men, and for the women, new love is coming for you in a positive way. Okay, for the men, it's more about money. For the men, it's more about connecting with the right people. But there's a lot of messages that you Capricorns are going to be receiving. I'm not seeing anything that is bad. I'm seeing love messages. I'm seeing people wants to work with you. I'm seeing the men trying to hold on and not showing their hands in whatever they have and that sort of a thing. So not to worry. So Monday, Tuesday, it's going to be positive. Wednesday, Thursday, is there's a lot of messages, fire energy that is coming in. Friday, Saturday, and the weekend is more about bringing ground and balancing in your world. It's more about holding on to what you have. In the weekend is more of working together, which is very, very positive, whether in family situation or whatever situation, you're trying to connect to others and working together. Okay, so that's good for you Capricorns. Let's look at the Aries. What is happening for the Aries in this week? So this is the first week of July, and we're looking at the Aries in the first week of July to see what exactly is going on. So for the Aries, we have the Eight of Swords. Those are seeing a situation clearly. Then we have the Three of Swords. You're seeing a lost situation. And then you see the Eight of Cups, which you're leaving that situation behind and moving for something. So there's a judgment call that is going to be coming out for the Aries. Monday, Tuesday, you're seeing a situation for what it is. It's as if everything is falling in place. Whatever that was happening, whatever that was transpiring, it's as if now everything is falling in place. Then we have the energy on Wednesday, Thursday of the Three of Swords. A loss is going to be coming in, and a loss could be a hurt. Something didn't go your way, but let it go. Okay, let it go, because we have to lose certain things to regain certain things. Okay. Then we have the Eight of Cups on Friday, Saturday. And this is going to be good, because what is happening is that you're just turning your back and moving forward. And it is a judgment call. So some of you are going to be receiving information, and it's going to be information of you losing something. But whatever you're losing, let it go, because it needs to release from your life. Okay, you guys have 3 times 8. Okay, because you also have the Eight of Pentacles, that you're working hard on whatever that you're doing. Some of you are going to be losing something, but it's okay, because obviously there was no need to have this thing, because I think this whatever that you're losing is not very important. It is where you decide, whatever that was transpiring, whatever that was happening, whatever the universe or your angels and guides think that, you know, this is not what you should have. Sometimes when we decide to move away from things or we lose things, it's not that we have lost it, it's that it has no higher intention for us. So let it go, okay? Look for financial abundancy, because the number 8, 3 times 8 is here. So look for financial abundancy coming in your life for you, Aries, okay? We are going to look at the Leos. What's happening for the Leos? Let's look at the Leos for the first week of July. What is happening for the Leos? Because for the Leos, you have the Queen of Coins. Some of you are going to be having a situation with a lady that is a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and the Two of Cups. Some of you could be falling in love with this lady, and some of you could be trying to work on a relationship with this lady. Six of Wands, good news is going to be coming in, okay? So some of you Monday, Tuesday could be dealing with a lady who is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. This lady is over the age of 40, a very positive person, and some of you could have very strong feelings for this person. Wednesday, Thursday, you have the energy of connecting with another person in a very positive way, and this could be bringing in a lot of work for you, or this could be building. So what I'm seeing here is that some of you Leos are going, and it can be your mom is a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, and you're both going to be connecting, and some of you might be moving back home with this person. Some of you might be asking this person if I could move back home. Some of you could be asking this person to come and work with you. Some of you could be asking her to support you in a financial situation. Whatever the question is to this lady, or the Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn person over the age of 40, it doesn't have to be the feminine energy. It can be it doesn't have to be feminine, it can be also masculine. The answer is going to be yes. So this week is basically what is a relationship you want to have with these fire sign people, earth sign people. It's going to happen. Whether it's business you want to go in with these earth sign people, it's going to happen. But you are going to be having a start with a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, or someone with the sign, or someone with the sign of these signs. So not to worry about what is happening. Things are going to be okay. Totally ridiculous. I have no idea what is going on here with my camera. You know, sometimes I'm trying to get these reading really out fast, and all of a sudden there is just some real weird things that is going on with my camera. So I am going to try to get out the readings and leave this situation so I can just focus on my readings. I tell you, you know, the negative energies are so powerful. So it's going to be a wonderful week for you Leos, whatever you are about to do with these Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, whether sun, moon, or rising sign, there it's a yes. Good news, it's a yes. Okay, let's look at the Sagittarians. Oh my god, Sagittarians, what's happening for the Sagittarians for the first week of July? The Sagittarians for the first week of July. Let's see what's happening for you, Sagittarius. Okay. All right. We have three cards all out. The Two of Swords. So Monday, Tuesday, some of you are going to be seeing a situation for what it is. Yes. A situation that you weren't seeing clearly is going to be so clear on Monday, Tuesday. Yeah, you are really going to be seeing something that was aligning itself. And then you have Wednesday, Thursday. You've decided to move away from this situation. Whatever it is, it's not helping you. It's not doing anything for you. So you've made a decision to just align yourself and move yourself away from this decision. The Empress is in the reverse form. So I haven't asked any question, but I'm going to ask a question. Okay. And the Ace of Pentacles is your outcomes. So this is positive. A lot of people keep on getting the Ace of Pentacles in this week. This is a mini reading because I can't. And I'm going to just, without them, help get what is going on for you guys. So your outcomes is the Ace of Pentacles. So some of you will be getting messages about your financial situations, financial stability, and that sort of a thing, which is actually good because you've decided that a situation isn't serving you anymore, so you're going to be changing to something else, which whatever the changes that you're about to make, it's going to be much better for you. Okay, so let's align ourselves and find out what is happening for you, Sagi. So, obviously, Monday, Tuesday, you're going to be, things are going to be clear to you what was happening. It's as if you know that something wasn't aligning in a positive way for you. And now you're deciding, okay, this is a situation, so I'm leaving this behind because this served me no longer. And it could be that some of you who are with a Capricorn is going to decide to move away, or this Capricorn is going to be leaving you and move away. Some of you could be losing a baby in this week. It could be happening Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Between Friday and Saturday even, you could be miscarriage. You could be having a miscarriage Friday, even Saturday. So if you're pregnant and you be aware of what you do between Friday, even and Saturday, you could be having a miscarriage. Ace of Pentacles, meaning, you know, no matter what is happening in this week, your financial situation is going to be good. So align yourself with positive energies to know you have no need to worry about your financial situation, because I'm seeing a lot of people worrying about their financial situation. Some people are dreaming for a better financial situation. Eight of Wands is here, where this means that a lot of businesses is going to be coming into you. So it is a week where you need to trust in the universe, okay? So for you, Sagi, it is a week where you need to trust in the universe and understand that as we trust in a higher power more greater than us, things will work out for us. But the good thing about it is that whatever is happening on Wednesday, Thursday, you decided, I'm leaving this. I'm moving away from this. This served me no longer. And it could be a career because the energy of the Empress is here. Or it could be something that has to do with your materialistic world. And you're going to decide, you know, I can do better. So I'm going to look for something that is going to be much better and much positive in my life. Okay? So let's move on to the obsolete. The obsolete people, what is happening for the obsolete? What is happening for the obsolete? Let's see what is happening for the obsolete. What is happening for the obsolete in the first week of July? You see, you guys are also carrying Sagittarius energy. Okay. So it's all about the outcome. Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups. Okay. So it's basically a nearly the same message, but the Queen of Cups comes in. So some of you are going to be seeing a situation about someone who is over the age of 40 and is a Pisces, a Cancer, a Scorpion. That is all about money for her. Okay? It could be your mom. It could be your sister. It could be your mother-in-law. It could be, but whatever it is, it's all about money for her. There's a lot of worries. This Two of Swords is coming in. There's a lot of worries. Whatever the worries is, that you guys are seeing something clearly about this person. And basically, whatever that is coming in, it has to do with work, and it has to do with money. And it's as if for some of you, you're going to be finding out that this lady have been taken. She has been scooping, meaning, you know, at work, it's as if she's taking money, but they're not seeing it. But they're going to find out that she has been doing this. It's as if they're still looking at something. So they are going to find out that this lady has been taking money off the top. Whatever she has done, however she does it, someone is going to come out. So let's hope that this is not your sister or brother or something like that. But I'm getting a message that whoever this person is, a Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpion, have been taking money at work. Some of you have seen this, and it's going to come out, but it's as if she's been watched. They have an idea that she has been doing this for quite some time, and they are watching. It's as if they're following the money, where it's going. You know, it's as if she has been taken. It's as if you saw it and you realize it, because you start to ask a lot of questions about a lot of things. And, you know, they're going to find out about her, whatever it is. So it could be your boss. It could be someone very close to you. Or it could be a friend. And you realize that this person have always have money. You know, and you're wondering, how is this? And then you're going to, it's as if you have a feeling that this was going on and it's going to come out. And some of you could be asked about it, whatever it is. Some of you could be asked about it. You know, there could be an investigation, and they're going to be asking you about it, you know, ask certain questions and speak up and tell the truth, because this lady has been not playing it's not doing the right thing. So whatever it is, and you've been asked about this lady, and say exactly what it is, but be honest about whatever you're going to be saying. Okay, so some of you are going to receive a message. This lady could be sending you a message about money, Ace of Pentacles, or you could be receiving money from this lady. She could be sending you a message, or you could be receiving money from this lady. Okay, so this could be a Pisces, Cancer, or a Scorpion. Alrighty, let's move on and see what is happening for the Pisces. What's happening for the Pisces Sun, Moon, and Rising sign? What's happening for the Pisces for the first week of July? Pisces Sun, Moon, and Rising sign. What's happening for the Pisces for the first week? A lot of inner strength. But it's as if you need to find inner strength, because it's in the reverse. Or no, some of you. And the Ace of Swords, you're using your intellect, you're using information, and you are going to be the receive the Page of Cups. So this is wonderful for you Pisces for this first week. Outcomes is the Seven of Wands. You're standing your grounds. I'm loving this for you Pisces, because whatever is happening is that you have inner strength, and this is good. Monday, Tuesday, you're going to find the inner strength. Wednesday, Thursday, you're going to be using information the way you you're going to be using your intuition to communicate. Wednesday, Thursday is a day of communication, but that is going, the communication that you're going to be given is that you're going to be standing your ground about something and said, look, you know, I've been looking at this and I'm thinking, and this is how I see it. You're going to be standing your ground, so you Pisces, and it's going to be good, because you are going to be standing up for, you know, someone else, and finding the inner strength to stand up against someone else to say, look, this is the way you have been going, it's not the right way, and that sort of a thing. Or have you ever looked at it this way? Or finding the inner strength to tell someone, look, you're off the rail, you need to back up and balance out yourself. And the person is going to appreciate this from you, the Page of Cups. So the person in return is going to say, thank you for, you know, being so abrupt and direct. Thank you for really saying exactly. The Aces are here, the Aces and the Page. Some of you could be having a child. You know, it is some of you could be having a child, or some of you could be having a child. Some of you men between the ages of 22 and 40 is going to be connecting with someone in love. New love is going to be coming in your life. So the men 25 to 45, or the people 25 to 45, new love is going to come in your life. But for most of you, you're going to be standing up against either an injustice, or you're going to be standing up for yourself and said, no, I think this is so unjust what is happening, and that sort of a thing. And be honest to someone, and just be honest and let them know that, you know, whatever you're doing is not in a positive way. So this is good. Oh, kudos to you, Pisces. Let's see what is happening for the Cancers in this first week. The Cancers who are not having birthday, first week of July 2017. What is happening for the Cancers in the first week of July? Five of Pentacles for the Cancers, King of Wands, and Seven of Swords. You Cancers. And the Nine of Cups, your wishes and dreams are coming out. So that is actually good. So Monday, Tuesday, you're going to have a situation where you feel a little bit out of balance, where you feel as if you're very out of balance Monday, Tuesday. It doesn't have to be with financial situation. It can be that you're not feeling yourself. You're feeling a little bit out of balance Monday, Tuesday. Wednesday, Thursday, you have to deal with someone who is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, an older person. This could be your father. This could be a message that coming in from your father that there is a financial instability that he has, or it could be that he has stolen something from you. He has stolen some money, or you could hear a message that this person has finally got caught for something that they did against you. Okay, so this person could have sold something or stole something from you, and he's caught. Okay, he is caught. So here, your wishes and dream, you're going to be happy that this has happened and this has transpired, because finally the truth of a situation is coming out. Okay, so this could be that Wednesday, Thursday, you know, whatever has transpired, this person who is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius over the age of 40, whatever has transpired, he has taken something. It could be money, it could be information, whatever, he is going to be caught, because your wishes and dreams are coming out, because some of you really hope and wish that this person would be caught, and it's going to happen. Some of you could have a situation with your father that is an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius that has done you something very dishonest, and now it's as if the truth is coming out, and you're feeling so happy and aligned with it, because it's as if finally people are seeing the truth of this person, what he has done and what he has what has transpired in my life because of this person, what he has basically lie, injustice, whatever situation. It could be an ex-business partner that you had worked with, and he has unjustly took something from you, and now it's going to be coming out, and now you're finally going to say yes, finally. Okay, so let's look at the Scorpion, and then let's see what's happening for the Scorpion Sun, Moon, and Rising in the first week of June. These are just little mini readings that is coming out. Some for the Scorpion Sun, Moon, and Rising. What is happening for the Scorpion? The Ace of Swords. You people are going to be and working together. Victory and success working together. You're waiting in limbo for something. And the Ace of Cups. Okay. So, Nine of Swords, a lot of worries for you, Scorpion, in this week. Whatever the worries is that you're using your truth, or you're coming harsh with harsh words, and you're trying to work to others, but you're in limbo because you're waiting for something. And this is the Ace of Cups. So, the Ace of Swords is always a victory and a success, but it's not a victory and success in this week. It is as if you're using your intellect to work together to receive something, but whatever it is, you're in the reverse form, or in the past you have used that to connect with the energy of love. Is it going to work this time? You know, it's as if you have been focusing on using the communication to work together, but is this the right thing? Be careful of what you say, you Scorpions, because it could be in love that you're trying to impress someone, but be careful how you come over to this person. You can either push this person away or pull them together. And which I'm seeing is as if you are, be careful about the communication, what you Scorpion do with someone who you love. Okay, be careful of what you're saying, be careful of the things that you're communicating in this week, because people could be taking them in the wrong way. So if I were you, because there's a lot of worries. There's a lot of worries, you Scorpions, or worrying, whatever the situation is. You're hanging in limbo and worrying. You're worrying if someone is going to return the love that you feel for them. But it depends on how you communicate, because your communication in this week has a lot to do with what is about to come, with what if people want to communicate and work with you. It's the way how you communicate. Communication is the key. Do not make people look stupid, or do not communicate in a way of you making people look stupid, because it's not going to work out for you guys. Okay, so new love is coming in. People are going to be wanting to connect with you, but be careful of the way you communicate. I want to say namaste until next time. I'm sorry for the little mini readings, but I had to get them out. Namaste. Have a good week.